Hello guys, welcome back to another video. Before we get into today's video, make sure you hit that like button. It really does help me out and it is greatly appreciated. Now then, what are we doing today? So we're going to be doing something that is potentially very simple and easy but effective. So we're going to be replacing the accelerator pedal, this thing right here, on my BMW E66 760 Li. Now you may be thinking, why are you swapping out the accelerator pedal? Now believe it or not, this is actually a pretty popular mod amongst the BMW 7 series, because I don't know if it's a model specific thing, but the throttle response does not seem where it should be, especially for a naturally aspirated petrol. You know, it should be lightning quick, the throttle response, but on my 760 Li in particular, you seem to push down the throttle, there's nothing, and then something. So I don't know if it's just because it is a luxury car and they, you know, you don't want to you don't want your passengers to experience, you know, jolting off the line or what, or if it's just because the, you know, the old design of the throttle pedal is old, I don't know. But this, as you can probably see there, this throttle pedal is actually from a 2014 BMW F10. Now, I believe this is the latest revision for the part number, and it should actually just be plug and play. So, yeah, it should just be a case of getting in the car, unbolting the original, which is just held in by one bolt, disconnecting the electrical connector and then installing this one in its place. So yeah, I'm pretty excited to see if we notice any difference. I've heard that it makes a lot, you know, night and day difference, but I guess we'll just have to wait and see. So yeah, without further ado, let's get outside and let's get cracking. So as we can see, we have the BMW 760 Li here in all its glory, and as you can hear, it is running. Now, I thought it would be a good idea just to show you guys what the stock throttle response is like, and then obviously we can compare it to the throttle response once we replace this accelerator pedal. So let's head inside and let's show you what the throttle response is like now. Okay, so I have a little bit of heat in the engine. I'm not going to go crazy, but let me just show you. So if I see, that is literally doing nothing, pushing down on that pedal. It kind of seems like I have to hold it down for at least half a second. Before it actually does anything. So yeah, it'd be interesting to see if just swapping out this pedal here actually makes a significant difference. Okay then, so let's move on to the removal of the accelerator pedal itself. And like I said, there is only one screw holding this in place. So it's just behind this little cap here, which you just need to try and remove. It's a pick tool. There we are. There's that little cap removed. Now it looks like an Allen screw or an Allen bolt. I'd say 5mm, 4 or 5mm Allen bolt. Yeah, 5mm. Should pull up. Yes, I'm gonna have to do, oh there we are, just have to slide it up, and now it's just gonna be a case of removing the electrical connector, which as you can see there is a tab on either side, so you're just gonna squeeze those together and that should pull off. There we are, that's the connector removed, that's the original accelerator pedal removed. Well, we have the pedal removed, may as well give the area a bit of a vacuum. I've also gave our new pedal a quick wipe over as well, just so it's nice and clean and fresh going in. But yeah, let's get it plugged in. The connector should be the same. Yep, seems to be in place. Let's get this hook back on. Nice and easy. Let's get our screw reinstalled. We'll reinstall that little cap. Just pushes in. That's just pretty much done. I guess we should get the engine fired up and see if we notice any difference. Okay, here we go then. First time firing it up. So we don't have any fault codes first and foremost. Just let the idle drop. Okay, so the idle has dropped. Now let's give it a few revs. You know what, that seems a lot more responsive now. Before I could do this and nothing would happen, but now it needs to rev every time. Which is brilliant. Over the moon with that. Guys, just got back from a little test drive and there is a big difference there. It seems like before I had to pretty much plant my foot all the way to the floor to get off the line nice and quick, and there would be a good half a second to a second delay between planting my foot to the floor and actually getting off the line, whereas now it seems like I have pretty much instant throttle response, which is pretty amazing really. The fact that just swapping over an accelerator pedal, which was I think £10 to £15, which is like $15 to $20 US dollars, that is, so yeah, not an expensive modification to do at all, and literally takes like 5 minutes to replace. Very simple and easy to do, as you saw in the video today. If you are interested in buying this, I'll try and find the product in some eBay and Amazon links. I'll sit them down below in the description. But yeah, I'd 100% recommend this. If you notice that your throttle response really isn't there, and you just want an extra punch, don't get me wrong, you're not going to automatically gain horsepower, but if you want a bit of a more sportier feel, a less sort of lazier and delayed throttle response, then yeah, I would recommend swapping out your accelerator pedal. Now, for those of you that are wondering, it's not only applicable to the BMW E65, E66 7 Series. I think it's pretty much applicable to any BMW with the older style accelerator pedal. I'm sure they changed it, I want to say around 2010, like when the BMW F10 5 Series came out. So yeah, if you do have a BMW kind of prior to 2010, it's definitely worth doing this mod if, of course, you want to do it. What else was I going to mention? Oh, the fact that it may only be applicable to automatics. I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe you guys know. Can you do this mod on a manual car? Are you going to notice the same sort of throttle response difference? Let me know, of course, if you know. But yeah, I'm going to wrap this video up. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed it. Please give it a like, leave a comment down below. Subscribe if you have not already done so. I'll see you all in that next one. Peace.